There is no sound. All right. Well, thanks for letting us show the video in motion and how you conceive, Tanya, this product coming into the fashion industry. And as you know, as we're looking at lifestyles in harmony with nature, our consumption and production is key to that. In fact, the United Nations Harmony with Nature program, if you look at the Sustainable Development Goals, the goal involving consumption and production also has in bullet 8 a target of lifestyles in harmony with nature. And I know that we had a chance to get a glimpse of your bottle, I Am Water Drop, on the first day as you presented the gift to Sandra Postol, and people have been talking about the bottle. And so it sets you up nicely to just answer a couple questions for us today as we go into a focus on fashion and the fashion industry. And the first question I have really, really quickly to you is, why the bottle? Why did you create and design this bottle?
Well, this bottle, thank you, Myra, for having me here. I'm very excited because I think fashion is going to play key in the sustainability and special in the usage and protection and awareness of water. Well, the bottle was inspired by my love and experience of water, along with knowledge studying water and understanding some of the behavior that was undermining the future of clean water. And I was quite disheartened for the last few decades seeing how consumerism and how we as consumers and corporations are treating water, taking it simply for granted as a commodity. And bottling water was one of the most disheartening things because we no longer were connected to water and we were receiving it in a plastic bottles that water, to me, I knew really decades ago that was not healthy for the water, and also it was not healthy for our relationship to the nature. So me also as a consumer and appreciating beauty and luxury and experience, I could not understand how people could just drink any kind of a water as long as corporations or businesses were labeling it as a healthy. So also as a media person, understanding the message of the product itself and the shape and not just what's labeled, I said, how would we bottle water, that water would still speak to us, that we would still relate to it, not like coming from the mechanical faucets through the plastic bottles that they were green and blue and yellow and square and round and so on, with absolutely no sensitivity understanding how water has to be stored and also communicating respect for water. So I decided to design the most beautiful water drop that would communicate with the relationship with the fashion industry and sustainable traveling and hospitality, beauty of water, so people would be intrigued by it, touched by it, awakened by it, and also along with sacred geometry that it has, that would actually teach people that water has to be stored in a container that can move. So they would actually start to understand that the delicate nature of our ecosystem, if we want to have it lively, if we want to have it not just plain survival, but if we want to thrive and enjoy it. And
thank you so much. You made an impression the bottle is out there, and I understand the museum shop at Missouri History Museum is carrying your bottle. Actually, they're carrying the carafe because you have two products, the carafe and the personal bottle that's coming out later summer, but is available, right, for pre-sale.